Hey guys, I hope you're not having such a bad time in the middle of all this complicated situation. Fortunately, there are streaming platforms and series that can help us survive, or at least help me survive this isolation. My personal favorite winner is the series that has changed everything and turned into the most watched non-English show on Netflix. I'm pretty sure I guess you guys all know which show it is that I'm talking about. Yup, Money Heist. Not sure if you have watched the new season or the whole series at all, but if you haven't, put it on your list. I wonder what is the reason for the overwhelming success of this series that is growing every single day. I mean, it's not even a month that season 4 is out and people are already looking forward to the 5th season. Could it be the handsome guys and the voluptuous ladies that appear in the series? The love and chemistry they have on the screen? Do you think that any of them are together in real life? That's why I'm here! To give you guys all the answers, so hit the little bell button and the subscription button and stay with me to find out all the real life couples of the series Money Heist. Without a doubt, talking about the groundbreaking series Money Heist is like talking about an unprecedented phenomenon. The show is not this most watched non-English speaking series in the history of Netflix for no reason. Many of the international fans might think that this production is one of the many original Netflix series, but that's not true because it was first aired on the Spanish media, Atres Media. However, there's no doubt that the series owes its international fame to everyone's favorite streaming service. That's why the fans around the world went crazy with the premiere of the 4th season and are already waiting for the 5th. Without a doubt, the first key was the trio made up of Alex Pina, the creator of the production, Jesus Colmenar, the director, and Miguel Amodo, who was in charge of the photography. This trio of geniuses managed to catch the attention of the public from the first minutes of the first episode. The story, the sequence of the images, and of course the masterful interpretations of each of the characters. All this resulted in the success that the show has today. And since we are talking about stories and characters, it's undoubtedly the romantic ones that have the most captured attention of the audience. But which one of them surpassed the screens and entered their real lives, and which stayed a fiction? So let's find that out. Tokyo's emotional instability in acknowledging that she was crazy about Ryo too late is in contrast with Ursula's confidence in real life. When a few years ago, she met Chino Darin on the set of La Empallada, she knew the same thing had happened to her fictional character with Ryo in Money Heist, and it was going to happen in real life with her with Chino. The truth is that Money Heist did not help in her romantic life, but it also brought her huge success, and currently, she's one of the most followed Spanish actresses on Instagram with more than 17 million last time we checked. And since we're talking about Tokyo, we have to talk about Ryo, aka Miguel Herrán, as well. Did you guys know that La Casa del Papel or Money Heist is not the only Netflix series that he has appeared in, which has been a huge success? I'm talking about the teenage Netflix series Elite. Not sure if you guys have watched that, but if you like Miguel, give it a try. Miguel is one of those stars who keeps his personal life as far away from the public eye as possible. Although, well, when you are such a big celebrity, it is almost impossible to keep everything private. Rumors have it that he is or was in a relationship with his colleague Sandra Escasena. Although there has been nothing official said yet, but there are rumors here and there about them. The two apparently were on each other's social media accounts, flirting and all. You guys, if you want to keep things quiet, this is not the way things should be done. Now that we have mentioned Elite, two actors who are both in that series and La Casa del Papel or Money Heist are Denver and Allison Parker, or Jamie Lorente and Maria Pedraza. Well, it turns out that the good vibes and chemistry between them on the screen went further and they decided to bring that to their lives and become a couple in real life. However, as professional as ever, on more than one occasion they have made it clear that it was not until the filming ended that they decided to make it official. In the series, there is a character who went from the good guys team to the criminal team. Do you know who I'm talking about? Exactly, we're talking about Lisbon, former Inspector Raquel Murillo, whose real name is Itziar Ituno. And in her case, she was the one who revealed some interesting details about her partner in an interview last year. Her exact words in Spanish, which I'm going to try and translate in English, were, "For a few years I have been in a relationship. He's from Iquitos, a city in the Peruvian Amazon. We live in the Basque Country. He's also a musician and is from the world of entertainment. We met doing theater. We are both artists, survivors, and I fell in love with his authenticity. We began by sharing the same concerns and the art world, and now here we are, moving forward little by little. Another character that is the fans' favorite is Nairobi, and for sure her death in season 4 was something that no one has recovered from still. But we are not talking about that in this video. Another video is created for you guys about why Nairobi had to leave the show. So for now, let's focus on her love life. There are some theories that Nairobi, portrayed by Alba Flores, was in love with Helsinki. Portrayed by Darko Pedic in the series, but in real life, the story of Alba's love life is completely different. There's not much information out there about Alba's private life, but some pictures suggest that she's not straight and she's in a relationship with the Spanish singer Ondina Maldonado. Did you know about this? So even though in the series Helsinki is gay, in real life as far as we know, he is straight and is happily married and also is the father of a 3-year-old son. Now that we have already talked about one of the homosexual members of the team, let's find out more about the life of Argentine, Rodrigo de la Serna, who plays Palermo. Just like Darko, he's not only married but also is the father of 3 little ones. The first one is Miranda de la Serna, the result of his first marriage to actress Erica Rivas. The kid has already become a 20-year-old young actress. However, with his current partner Ludmila Romero, Rodrigo became the father of Olivia, and only at the beginning of this year, they had another little boy. Now, it's time to talk about the fan favorite characters of the series. The first one is Pedro Alonso, who is in an official relationship with Tixi Jambis, a Parisian of Serbian descent, who, as she defines herself on Instagram, is dedicated to hypnotherapy. Not much is known about Pedro, but just a few months ago the actor returned to Spain along with Tatiana, as she is actually called, but before returning to his home continent, Pedro lived in Peru for a while. Shortly after his return, Alonso gave an interview to Vogue magazine in which he said that he and Tatiana had met in Paris, and it was love at first sight. The first day I met her, without flirting, we started talking, and at the end of the conversation, I gave her my phone in case she wanted to do something in those 11 days that I was staying there. She told me that she was a hypnotherapist in the gardens of Giverny, the same ones from Monet's paintings. That is exactly when she offered to take my regression that originated the second book. And what book is he talking about? Libro de Filippo, or Philip's book, which is kind of an autobiography with hints of an initiatory journey, which includes some color illustrations that the actor himself painted. This man does not stop surprising us, each and every single one of these things that he does in every field. So in case you didn't know, among his other various talents, Pedro is also a painter. Oh, and don't think I have forgotten about the professor. But before diving into his wonderful love story with his wife, the stylist Blanca Clemente, did you know that Alvaro Morte almost didn't make it into acting? Everything happened one night when Alvaro was about to fall asleep with his wife while watching a boring play. And at that very moment, the two of them wondered why on earth this classical theater had to be so flat and joyless. Precisely for this reason, in 2012, he decided to become a theater director, and together with his wife, they opened their own production company called 300 Guns. A fun fact about these two is that they have adorable twins, Julieta and Leon. And speaking of Alvaro's wife, she has played a key role in the actor's life. When in 2011, Alvaro found out that he had a cancer tumor in his left thigh, he believed that it was the end and that he would have no chance to fulfill his dreams. However, Blanca was always by his side to offer her unconditional support when the actor needed her most. Fortunately, together they overcame the tough battle against cancer. Undoubtedly, having gone through such a bitter time in his life helped him to have a very different perspective on life, a much more realistic, humble, and simple one to appreciate what is truly important in this world. And nowadays, despite his enormous fame and popularity, the actor knows how to keep his feet firmly on the ground. And in photos he shares on his social networks, you can see how he behaves like an exemplary father, entirely dedicated to his beautiful family, and also everyone that knows him says that he is the neighbor everyone wishes to have. Today, when questioned about that difficult period in their lives, he responds that although the overwhelming success he achieved thanks to the series is something they never imagined, the fact that they fought for his life together and won is something that cannot be compared to the success they achieved. And as he said, after that very hard episode in his life, there is nothing that really worries him. now that we have gone through all the real-life love stories of Money Heist characters, do you feel like you know them better? Which couple is your personal favorite? Which fictional couple do you wish was real? Now, let's talk about all of that in the comments, and remember to like, share, and become part of our Curious Sips family by subscribing to our channel. Oh, and also, don't forget about our Instagram account. So, see you next time!